Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss the swap. A swap is basically an exchange of one cash flow for another. Example, Mr. Finn exchanges the return generated by his shares of Facebook with the return generated by the shares of Microsoft held by Mr. Toon at the end of the year. Both of them hold shares worth $10,000. If Facebook gives a return of 5% and Microsoft gives a return of 2%, Mr. Finn will give $500 to Mr. Toon and Mr. Toon will pay $200 to Mr. Finn. Thus, both of them are able to get a return on the other's share without actually owning it. However, like any other derivative contract, only one of them will experience a favorable outcome. In this case, Mr. Finn is a net loser and was better off without the swap contract. Swaps are OTC contracts and do not trade on exchanges. These contracts are customized to suit the needs of both the parties. Such contracts are usually used only by large businesses and institutions for hedging or speculation. The transaction could be done with the help of an intermediary who would charge a fee. In most swaps, parties do not make any initial payments to each other when they enter into the agreement. As these contracts are not regulated, risk of default is a major concern. The most common swap is the interest rate swap. Other types are commodity swaps, currency swaps, debt equity swaps, total return swaps, and credit default swaps. Let us understand these swaps in detail. Interest rate swap. Suppose X Corp has a bank loan of $1 million on which it pays a floating rate of interest. As the floating rate keeps fluctuating, today it could be 4% and a year later it could be higher or lower. If the interest rate increases, the company would have to pay a higher interest. X Corp wants to hedge this risk and wants to convert this uncertain liability into a predictable one. LIBOR is commonly used as the benchmark floating rate. LIBOR is the interest rate at which major global banks lend unsecured short-term loans to one another. LIBOR is quoted for five major currencies, that is US dollar, the euro, the British pound, the Japanese yen, and the Swiss franc for seven different maturities. However, LIBOR could soon be replaced by a new alternative reference rate, such as the secured overnight financial rate. On the other hand, let us assume Y Corp has issued a fixed coupon paying bonds worth $1 million. Every year it has to pay a fixed interest of 5% to its bondholders. Y Corp speculates that floating interest rates will fall in the future and will be lower than 5% if it could convert the existing fixed rate liability into a floating rate liability. The interest cost will reduce. X Corp and Y Corp enter into a swap contract in which X Corp agrees to pay the fixed rate of 5% and Y Corp agrees to pay the floating rate LIBOR. The notional principal is taken as $1 million and the swap will be settled annually for the next 5 years. The notional principal is theoretical and is not exchanged between the parties. Suppose during the first settlement period, the LIBOR was 4%. X has to pay $50,000 to Y and Y has to pay $40,000 to X. This payment can be netted and X will pay $10,000 to Y and the transaction is settled. Let us take a moment to understand the cash flow for both parties. This scenario has worked favorably for Y as it was able to bring down the interest cost. If during the second settlement period, the LIBOR becomes 6.5%, X has to pay $50,000 to Y and Y has to pay $65,000 to X. This can also be netted and Y will pay $15,000 to X. Let us take a moment to understand the cash flow for both parties. This scenario is favorable for X as it is able to save $15,000 in bank interest. Under this swap contract, X will always owe $50,000 to Y and is thus able to convert an uncertain liability into a fixed amount of expense. This is a plain vanilla interest swap. As swaps are customized contracts, payments can be made monthly, quarterly, annually, or at any interval determined by the parties. The payment dates are known as settlement dates, and the time between them is the settlement period. As the same currency is used in both fixed and floating cash flows, the payments can be netted. The transactions are netted on settlement to reduce default risk, but some risk will always remain in OTC agreements. Floating rate payer believes that floating rates will fall and will be lower than fixed rates. Fixed rate payer believes that floating rates will increase and will be more than the fixed rates. Commodity swaps. In a commodity swap, one party pays the fixed agreed upon rate of a commodity in exchange for the floating price of the same commodity. The terms used are fixed leg and floating leg. Usually, these swaps are made on crude oil and related components. Similar to interest rate swap, the cash flows are netted and the party who must pay more will pay the difference. Example, an airline has entered into a commodity swap on 1,000 barrels of fuel with a dealer and has agreed to pay a fixed rate of $80,000 to the dealer for the next 4 quarters. The dealer has agreed to pay the floating rate, that is, the actual market price of fuel on the settlement date. If at the end of first quarter, the actual market price per barrel is $78, the airline will pay $80,000 and will receive $78,000 from the dealer. This payment can be netted and the airline pays the difference of $2,000 to the dealer. At the end of second quarter, if the price per barrel is $81, the airline will receive the net value of $1,000 from the dealer. Using the swap contract, the airline is able to maintain a fixed expenditure of $80,000 towards the quarterly consumption of fuel. Fixed leg payer feels that commodity prices will increase. Floating leg payer feels that commodity prices will decrease. Debt-equity swaps. A debt-equity swap involves exchanging repayment of debt for equity. Suppose Z Limited has a $5 million debt. Due to financial distress, it is unable to make the interest and principal repayments. Q Corp is willing to repay the debt directly in return for a 30% equity ownership of Z Limited. No cash is paid to the counterparty in this swap. It is used by financially distressed companies to refinance their debt or reallocate their capital structure and keep it within a target range.